Hello, my name is Jason Key. I'm 29 years old, Korean American, and I live in New York City. I'm currently a PhD student working in biomedical engineering research lab. And in this video, I hope to show you guys what a day in the life is like for a scientific researcher in academia. So I like to keep my morning easy and stress-free as possible. So I developed a routine that I follow quite strictly every morning. And I think you could have guessed already, I'm really into working out and fitness. I'm a meathead. I lift, I drink protein.
Okay, I feel pretty awake now after the coffee and the protein shake. So, it's time for me to head to the gym.
Once I leave the house, I don't come back until really, really late. So I try to pack as much as I can.
Gotta get the workout in.
I live in the west part of Midtown in New York City, called the Hudson Yards. This area used to be a graveyard for trains and buses. But since the completion of all the development and constructions, this area became really, really posh. I go to a gym called Equinox. It's one of the more luxurious gyms, I guess, in Manhattan. They have swimming pools, indoor, outdoor, and jacuzzi. So they have a lot of fancy facilities. They also offer spin classes, yoga, and aerobic, which I never used. So, you may be asking, how does a graduate research assistant afford to live in Midtown and have an expensive gym membership? Do I have a sugar mama? Do I come from a rich family? I actually run a side business, and I also co-founded a startup, both of which that pays me a modest income monthly. Even though I have a very expensive gym membership, I live a very modest life. I don't travel, I don't go out to eat, I don't go on dates. I don't have a girlfriend, huge money saver. And I actually promised myself not to date until after the PhD. My only focus is to graduate this year. So yeah, this is the way I start my day. Getting the games, going to the gym.
So it turns out today is 19 degrees Fahrenheit. That's really cold for New York. Woo!
It's time to commute. Right now I'm in Midtown. My university is in Harlem, which is about 30 minutes on the train. some people are not big fans of the public transit, but I love it because this is one of my few opportunities to be in an environment with a lot of people. Majority of the people in science, especially at the PhD level, don't get a chance to work with a lot of other people. So for me, I enjoy the hustle and bustle of the commute. Once I get on the train, this is when my workday actually begins. I start reading research papers and write my own research papers. I started doing this by watching my professors, my PhD advisors. They're always working on the train and just everywhere and anytime because the work is so demanding. The commute all the way up to Harlem took about 40 minutes. Harlem is historically a black community. And one of the staples of Harlem, or just uptown in general, are the bodegas that are located at every corner. You can get deli sandwiches, cheap coffee, and just a quick place to go in and out and get whatever fix you need for the day, and it's cheap. All right, we're here now at the City College of New York. This is the back-end entrance of the university. In this video, everything looks new, but this is actually one of the oldest colleges in New York City. It was founded in late 1800s.
Alright, so here we are.
This is the Center for Discovery and Innovation at the City College of New York. On the right side, that's the CUNY Research Building. Let's get it. Sorry about that. Forgot it again. Not thinking straight. So the goal of academic research is to push the boundaries and expand the knowledge of a particular field in engineering or science. We're not necessarily trying to invent a wheel, but to move the needle in a very specialized and focused area. The work that I'm doing is related to the field of neuroscience, where we apply engineering knowledge such as machine learning, computer vision, and signal processing. We use these tools to understand how the brain represents different cognitive functions such as vision, emotions, motor movement, arousal, just anything that your brain does. Right now, I'm preparing for a presentation, which I will give this afternoon. Now it's the holiday season, so I don't think that many people are gonna show up, but I'm still gonna do my best job to give a good talk. In my lab, there are about 30 people working either as PhD students, postdocs, masters, and every Thursday a PhD student is required to present a topic related to their field of research. And before the presentation, we gather for some coffee and pizza and to socialize.
Oh, that's good. I agree.
Fine.
No, but anyway, it's good practice.
Yeah.
You should watch yourself giving a talk. It's horrifying.
I did that for that.
Maybe not you.
No, I.
Let's start. So what I'm trying to get at is to understand how visual processing changes based on different factors. And there are a number of factors that can change the way the brain responds to visual stimulus. One, tension, arousal, engagement, reward, multi-sense activation. And this paper, again, also addresses locomotion. So I'm going to start with a case with mice, which is people's smartphone. And we're going to address the EEG, that is EEG's related to physics and EEG. So one of the hypotheses, so the main hypothesis of this experiment is that there's some sort of game with MSTV, locomotion, or some sort of visual protection loop policy. One was suppression. Exactly. So, this is a
getting a PhD is something you have to put your entire life into, at least for those 5 years. And I'm not gonna lie, this work is both mentally and emotionally draining. It really takes toll on someone's mental health. The task of learning, reading, writing, performing experiments, it's unending. To be honest, it could go forever. But I see the light at the end of the tunnel, both literally and figuratively. So, let's finish. Thank you so much for sticking this far into the video. I really appreciate your time and your support. And if you're new, please consider subscribing. and I'll see you guys later. Connection, this empathy, so much stronger than our good times through anything. Personally, I think that it's a better day when the light shines and I see the darkness run away. Let the bad times roll.